Hello, I'm Robin Whalley, welcome to Lenscraft. Today, I'm looking at ACDSee Photo Studio Ultimate 2020, and I'm exploring the question, can it replace the Adobe Lightroom Library module? This was a suggestion from someone following another video I did, comparing Lightroom with Exposure X5. If you haven't heard of ACDSee before, I'm not surprised. But you might be surprised to learn that ACDSee's been around for a very long time. When I first moved to digital photography, back in 2003, I was desperate to find software to help manage my photos. At the time, Adobe Lightroom didn't exist, and there weren't many affordable options. What I ended up using was ACDSee Photo Manager that's evolved into the Photo Studio Ultimate we see today. But before we get into the review, I need to tell you that I've been given the license key for the 2020 software. Ordinarily, I wouldn't accept offers like this, but I've made an exception with ACDSee. That's because I previously purchased Photo Studio Ultimate 2019. I've intended to publish videos using the software for a while, so the free license codes just prompted me to do this. And even though I got the key for free, you're still going to get my honest opinion about the software. I also need to apologise for the PC that I'm using for this video. It's almost 9 years old and may struggle with some of the processing. I usually use a Mac for my editing and recording, but ACDSee Photo Studio Ultimate only runs on Windows. There is a Mac version of the software, but I don't have a license for that. If you're a Mac user and looking for a Lightroom replacement, I'd recommend downloading the trial to see if it works for you. I'm starting with the software in the Manage module. If you look along the top right of the screen, you can see the different modules, which is a similar approach to Lightroom. On the left of the screen, you can see a panel headed up Folders. This lists the folders on my computer and network, as well as including many different shortcuts. If I select a folder, I can see a grid of thumbnails of the media files. I also have the option to connect to my C drive, which is the ACDSee's cloud storage. Now, I've had a look at the ACDSee website, and it appears the cloud storage is only available for subscribers. Whilst many people are trying to avoid subscriptions, this one does actually appear to be good value and gives you access to a lot of software. The downside for me though is that it's a limited storage size for the cost, and the largest drive I could actually find is 50GB, which is nowhere near enough for me. That said, I don't think this is aimed at professional photographers. And in any case, I have access to my Microsoft OneDrive, which is about 1TB of data. Now, there's a lot on this screen and the layout isn't quite as I'd like. But I do have the option to customise a few things. For a start, I can increase the size of the thumbnail previews. This makes them easier to see and the screen appears a lot less cluttered. There are also some missing panels, as well as others that I don't need. If I right click at the top of the screen, I can display a pop-up of the available panels. I can also access these from the Panels menu. As well as being able to hide or display the different panels or panes, there are 4 toolbars which can be hidden or displayed using the View menu. Now, something that ACDSee has that Lightroom doesn't is the ability to save the configuration as a workspace. This is very similar to the workspace idea in Photoshop. If I select the Manage Workspace option in the toolbar, I can save the configuration or load an existing one. When it comes to managing images, there are a few features that I find essential. The first is to be able to apply a rating and a colour label to images. In ACDSee, I can do this using the Properties panel, where there's an Organize tab. I then have a series of filters and sorting options along the top of the screen that I can use. For example, I can show all the images with a rating of 2, or 3, or even any unrated images. If I want to then add a rating to any of these images, I can use the Metadata panel. Or I can use the icons at the top of each of the thumbnails. The ratings are perfect for sorting your best images. Whenever you add a new set of images to your computer, set the rating of the best ones to 1. Then go through the ones that you have a rating of 1 to see if there's any that you think are examples of your best work. You can then set those ratings to 2. You can easily devise your own system for what the ratings mean, but it's worth spending a little bit of time on this. Like ratings, you can also set the colour labels for your images. Again, you need to devise a system of what each colour means. For example, I use a red label to indicate any images that I have on sale with a stock library. I then know not to include those images for downloads in tutorials. Now, let me show you a feature that I didn't know I needed until I saw it. Along the top of the thumbnail grid, I can select a different view from the drop-down. But that's not the best bit. When I select the Choose option from the menu, I can design what information to display below each of the thumbnails. When I'm working on a large batch of images for, say, a stock library submission, I can instantly see the ones that I may need to work on still. The Properties panel also has a metadata tab, allowing me to edit the image metadata. For example, my first image has a copyright notice applied to it, but the others don't. I can quickly apply the same copyright notice to other images using a preset I created. To create a new copyright notice for 2020, I can use the Manage Presets option from the drop-down. I can enter my copyright information into the relevant fields and then save this with a new name. The new preset is then available in the drop-down list for selection. Something else that's very important for my work is being able to add keywords to images. The Keywords feature in ACDSee is also in the Properties panel under the Organize tab. When I select an image with keywords assigned, I can see them in this list. If I want to add more keywords, I can click the keywords in the list, but I can also enter keywords in this field separated by a comma. This also adds the new keywords to the keywords tree. Now you may have noticed that this list of keywords is hierarchical. The way to create the hierarchy is to create a new keyword, manually assigning it to another. Unfortunately, it's not possible to drag and drop the keywords to reorganize them. Perhaps this is something ACDSee will consider adding in a future release, and I really think it's important to have features like this. A further way to manage and work with keywords is by creating keyword sets. For example, if you have a group of related keywords, you can group them into a set. You can then select the set to display and click the keywords to add them to image or images. ACDSee has the option to create an entirely new keyword set, which then appears in the list, or you can edit an existing set. Once you've finished editing, save your changes. This is simple and extremely flexible. Collections is another feature of Lightroom that I use a lot. They allow me to group together sets of images from many folders anywhere on my computer. ACDSee also supports hierarchical collections to help organize images, but they work slightly differently. I'll start by creating a new collection set called Countries, which can hold one or more collections. I'll then create a collection within the collection set, calling it Singapore, and another one called Australia. Now I'll select a group of images and add them to the Singapore collection. Then another group and add them to the Australia collection. I can then filter my display for the current folder. If I change folders, the filter still applies, but only in the current folder. It is possible to search across your entire catalogue of images, rather than just filtering the current folder. But for that, you need to work with categories. Here, I've already created categories for Singapore, Australia, and New Zealand. I can then select groups of images and assign them to the relevant categories. Now, if I open the catalogue panel, I can select the category that I want to display. If I select Australia, ACDSee displays the thumbnails for all the images across my entire catalogue that are in the Australia category. I'm not just restricted to the current folder. And as before, I can then filter the current view if I need to. But it isn't only categories that you can search the catalogue for. I could search for labels or keywords. In fact, you can create searches that find images based on almost anything you can imagine. It also feels exceptionally fast. Now, one final feature that I want to show you is the image basket. This is great if you want to temporarily group images for some reason. I'll add a single new one and call it Australia, but you can create and display multiple baskets. Now, I can add images that I find to the relevant basket as I move between folders. I can then select all the images in my basket and change their metadata together. You could use this feature for all kinds of purposes in your workflow. Overall, the Manage module feels like it could do everything that Lightroom Library module could do, and possibly a few additional things. The only negative I can find so far is that it has too many options for me. I'm finding it difficult to wrap my head around everything that's possible. But I do think, given a little time, I could soon become very proficient in organising my images with ACDSee. That's it for now, but in a future video I'll be looking at another ACDSee module. If you're interested in alternatives to Lightroom, I'll include a link in the video information below to an article on my website. Don't forget to subscribe and please share this video. I'm Robin Whalley, you've been watching Lenscraft, I'll see you soon for another video.